Okay, so we are recording to the cloud. Now, I did want to mention, Kristen, and I'm not sure if you heard Fred, because I couldn't tell what your video and your audio was doing, and Mary too. I called this afternoon the Meads and left a message saying that we were awaiting what we had requested. Remember the letter from the building inspector as to why he had denied their project, and Roger had made a request for a better plan with more details on it. We have received nothing via email. I asked them to be prepared to give us that information, and if it was easier for them to email it to me, to please do so. I gave them my email address. I'm checking now, nothing. So I don't know, it is 6:41. So I'm not sure what we are to do.
Well, I think in other cases, especially the older days when people were traveling, we would give people a little bit of maybe a 20-minute grace period to
yeah,
to see if they showed up or zoomed in this case. So we ought to give them a little bit of time, but and then the question becomes, if they don't appear, then what do we do? So, but maybe we should wait till we have to cross that bridge.
Yes. Yeah, I agree. No, I think we should absolutely wait until 7:00. And my inclination would be, if they do not come until, if they are not here by 7, is that I would certainly call them again, either this evening or tomorrow. I mean, we just continued the hearing. We haven't closed anything. So they still have time if they want to come back next month. I just want to verify this because I was looking at this earlier. Because we haven't closed the public hearing, we have 90 days following the closing of the public hearing to take any action. We haven't closed the hearing, so it's not like we're up against a deadline.
Right. Right.
So, Deborah, you said you called today and left a message, and you left your email address also.
I did. The only number that I had, Mary, was the one on the special permit application. And that was the number I used. And it's also, it was clear that it's also I remember the daughter in the Mead family had said she was a potter. And so there was reference to a pottery business on the voicemail as well.
Okay.
So I certainly used the number that was, that's not anything related. So I used the number, as I say, on the special permit application. Beautiful day, early summer.
It is, yeah.
For 2 days, and it's going to be back to normal, I guess.
Temperatures.
Is it?
Yes, going to cool off next week.
And get some rain, I hear.
Yes.
Hopefully.
Yes, I know. I hope we don't get a drought again the way we did last summer, but my God, it's certainly heading that way.
Yeah.
I hate the hot weather.
I love it.
I grew up in South Carolina, and I never noticed it when I was a kid, but now when I go back down there, I'm like, I'm going to die.
It's so humid down there. I do.
I once worked with a guy who used to be dragged by his parents every summer to visit his grandmother for a couple of months. He said he used to wake up in the middle of the night, and he'd have to run himself a cold bath, and he'd sit in it crying because he was a little kid and he couldn't stand it and he had no power.
Oh my God.
I used to do the same thing. I'd get up in the middle of the night and run a cold bath and lie in it, and I'd fall asleep, and my parents would find me in there in the morning. They'd be like, "What are you doing?" And I'm like,
"Kristen, you're lucky you didn't surviving. Drown."
No, I can't drown. I was either a mermaid or I always said a porpoise, but now my girlfriends say, man, I was a manatee.
I have to confess, I do love this hot weather. I probably was born living in the wrong climate. I kind of wait all year for this weather.
Yeah, okay.
I wait all year for it to go away.
We call you people lizards.
Probably true.
On a hot rock.
I am keeping an eye on the waiting room, folks. Nobody's there. So I guess since I called today, my inclination would be to call tomorrow, just in case something is amiss, not to bother them again tonight.
When did we meet? Was it a full month ago?
Yeah, it was our
May meeting.
Yeah, I had pulled up the documents just in case. It was our May 2nd. Meeting, because we met twice. We were going to meet twice. Right. Maybe it was May 4.
Okay.
Yeah, it was our regularly scheduled meeting. Let's double check it.
Do we have anything coming up for the future meeting, Mary?
Well, the only thing is the person or people who want to do an expansion of a dental practice on Old State Road. Apparently, when Deborah sent him a whole explanation of why don't you check with the building inspector if he doesn't want to give you a building permit because of need for a special permit, then you can apply for that and come see us. That apparently went to her spam email and she never saw it. She's been in contact again, wrote yesterday, and Deborah and I have both communicated with her since then by email. Her last letter explained about apparently she'd gone looking for Deborah's letter and found it in spam, and she can't come tonight, but she's hoping to catch us for the next meeting. Well, if she talks to the building inspector in between, maybe she won't need a special permit, then we won't need to have a hearing. But depending on what he says and when it is that he says it and when we hear about it, it's kind of up in the air.
Yeah.
Okay. So they're looking at expanding their office space?
Well, she has a little drawing that she dropped off, or her husband did, back in April with Amy LaValle, who sent it out to the planning board and the zoning board saying, this is all I have, this is all they have. They want to expand their practice. And it isn't enough information on this drawing. But it's the planning board discussed it a little bit, very briefly, when they got Amy's email, and they said, well, you know, we can't do anything with this. The zoning board would be the ones to make the call if there's more. Apparently, someone knew that the property is already an existing non-conforming property. But as they said, they don't know whether it's going to need a zoning
where is it
or not. 64, I think, was the number. Old State Road.
It's like behind the Sugarloaf shops. I had Googled where it is.
Right, because I remember when Mary sent me that, I had asked Roger for his opinion, and Roger said, we don't have anywhere near enough information to make a decision as to whether or not it needs even to come before us. And so, you know, the building inspector can make that call. I'm actually sort of surprised that my email, Mary was great about finding exactly when I sent that to them, because it was back in April.
Yeah, the end of April. I think the planning board talked about it the 26th, and you sent your letter the 27th.
Yeah,
and we never heard anything back.
And
but we didn't know that's because she hadn't seen your letter.
Right. Right, right. And so, yeah, we found out today it had been sitting in spam. So,
well, it's in our commercial development zone. So I don't know why they wouldn't approve it. They want more commercial there.
Yeah. Well, maybe there isn't a problem with anybody approving right. something. The problem right now is not enough information for anybody to make a decision, I guess. because of the quality of the drawing and what was missing from it.
Well, they'll figure it out or not, or decide something else.
Does anybody know the Old State Road in that area? Is it a town road and town maintains it, or is it private because there's residents on there? Well,
I don't know.
Because if you look on the other side of 91 where the truck stop is, they're parking trucks on the part of the Old State Road. And I think the truck stop owns that portion of that road.
Oh.
I don't think the town does anything to maintain that part of Old State Road. So I don't know the other side of 116, whether the town maintains that or not.
Has anybody noticed like a developing little, I don't know what word to use, trashy area? If you come down Westbrook Road, down the hill, and you hit Chestnut Plain, like directly smack ahead of you where they put the new stop sign, there's a trailer bed truck that's been parked there for about 2 years.
And now on Chestnut Plain Road?
Yeah. And now they got some cars that are tucked behind the trailer.
Yeah, I have noticed that, and several citizens have asked me about it. And I've had to say, there's nothing we can do about that. That's something you need to take before the zoning board. I don't know if anyone noticed that was
you mean before the building inspector?
But yes, excuse right. me, before the building inspector. In fact, my last...
Yeah, we don't want it.
I had tried to... And that last paragraph that I put in the zoning report was to remind people that we're not an enforcement board because we get so many requests like that. But I'm not sure who that is, Roger.
No, I have no idea who it is other than... Yeah. Every time I come down there, I curse under my breath at it. I don't want to prejudge.
No. Kristen, what?
I'm just saying it's very easy to find out whose property it is. And I mean, so, you know, there are a couple of properties in town that are a little, you know, I actually want to say, do these people need help? Do you know what I mean? I mean, like, you know, people with the bad roofs and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I don't know. Is there a town thing where people go around and actually look at these subpar deficient properties and find out why, or if they need help, or if we just need to, you know, whip them into shape?
Yeah, I know what you're saying. I mean, I don't even know. Yeah, because Deborah's point of who owns it. I'm not even sure what house it's affiliated with, because it's kind of out there on its own.
The other board that I'm on is the Valley Neighbors, and that's our Aging in Place initiative. And we don't have a mechanism. I mean, in all the either sort of private, citizen initiated endeavors and the state endeavors, a lot of times people have to either ask for help, or a neighbor or law enforcement would report it to social services in some way so that people could, you know, make a wellness check on someone. But if none of that happens, things get worse before they get better.
Yeah, the other thing I noticed, a new building going up, and I don't know if it's commercial or going to be a business, on Haydenville Road, right past Dickinson Hill Road. I think my hands there put something up.
Those are my neighbors, the Moynihans.
Yeah.
They own a big trucking company, and they also put that place up on Route 5 and 10,
right
across from the florist there. And the young boys, I mean, they're all great kids. They also they plow the towns. They have big plow trucks, and they're race car drivers.
Right.
So they have every toy, and I used to say $100,000 race cars, but now they're in their 20s, so I think they're probably $500,000 race cars.
Yeah. But that's their garage, right, Kristen? They're getting the trucks and vehicles undercover.
Yes.
Yeah, because I don't think technically that they can have the business in that zone. So I think it's a residential garage per se.
Right. Yeah, I don't know if it's just a garage or a business, but I think all of that is zoned still residential.
Oh, it is. It definitely is.
It's huge.
It is immense. I know, it looks like it could be an airplane hangar. Yeah. But it looks better than having the trucks along the road.
Well, yeah.
Well, the other brother put a fence up and blocked all of everything so you can't see it over there on 5 and 10. Oh. He's got like 20 big dump trucks over there.
Oh, okay, yeah. And what's on 5 and 10? They added another building to that barn on the north side. It just seems strange to do that. I don't know.
I'm not picturing that one.
They're hardworking kids, and they have money, and they like to
buy stuff.
Have other vehicles there. I don't know, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I think we might be being stood up, folks.
All right.
I mean, we can wait till 7 o'clock, but there is no one in our waiting room.
So we should think ahead. So I don't
have never for just so I don't lose track of it. What was it? Could you just give me again, or Roger, what Roger asked for by way of a better plan last time? Was there anything? There must have been.
Would it help? Let me share the screen, Roger, and you can see what they did submit. And let me make this just a tiny bit smaller so people, yes. I believe we don't have any setbacks. We don't have, we had a visual rendering. And I believe, as I recall, we definitely asked them to give us the rationale that the building inspector gave when he denied the special permit and sent them to us. And then Roger, I'm sorry, I'm going backwards. So this is the plan we have.
Yeah, I wanted a site plan that shows neighbors, north, south, okay. east, east, west, setbacks.
Yeah.
All those good things.
And the other thing I remember, and I was so glad that Kristen had the memory of this, is that it was very hard to determine whether, I mean, they said they were coming for an addition to a single family home, but at the same time, the couple and the mother were going to be living there, and the addition seemed to be having a full, like a kitchen and bathroom and in addition to the other one. But then Kristen remembered that the house had always had two kitchens. So it could be just an addition. And that's what I was wondering if maybe the building inspector could clarify for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that they, when it was built, there was a family, a divorced couple there.
That's
and,
right.
And the dad was downstairs, and there was a, you know, more of a studio, not quite a one bedroom, but a bathroom, a kitchen, and a walkout.
Yeah.
But what they were proposing was that beautiful garage right. with the little point and the copper roof and all of that on it. They're going to rip the whole garage off and then put the addition there.
Yeah, yeah. So it is 7. I will phone them tomorrow mid-morning just to see if they would like to go forward. Now, Roger, should they decide they don't want to, do they need to come back and withdraw without prejudice?
Well, I think I wouldn't say come back, but they should send in
a letter.
Yeah.
Addressed to the ZBA. Okay. Yeah. I won't assume that that's what they're going to do. I'll just call and say, and if something has happened or they didn't get their information together and they want to come back, we can just add them to the agenda, Mary, for July. Would that be all right?
Yeah, as we have up until the, well, you, I think you, as long as you have an agenda that's been established,
right,
48 hours before, you can keep adding to it, is my understanding, as things come up. But
okay,
you can adjust it as you need to.
So what's our July date?
Our July date is, would be July 6th.
Why don't you give them a soft deadline of July 1st to get us any new information or the new information that we requested?
I think that's a really good idea. July 1st is a Saturday, so why don't I give them to the last week in June?
Yeah, just so we don't have to go through this again.
Yeah.
And then if those other folks come forward, we were just talking about with the dental practice, we could have it on that same July 6th date.
Okay. I will, as I say, I'll make that phone call tomorrow mid-morning. I will send an email to everybody just letting you know if I reached them, anybody, or if I had to leave a message. I will include the soft deadline of end of June to let us know. Let me just make a note. And because we have, do we have any further business before the board?
Mary, where do we stand on minutes?
Minutes have suffered. There have been so many meetings. It's just been, April was horrible getting ready for it.
Been busy.
It was terrible just meeting, and there has been all sorts of other stuff.
Well, I know, but if by some chance we don't have any other business on July 6th,
I don't,
maybe that's a good time to look at.
I have many, many things that are all converging with June deadlines. One of them is my hours worked. One of them is things that I have to do about, I now have to make, I'm the one who has to make sure that the ad bills get paid properly, matched up, you know, people pay them, but we get a bill from the recorder, and I have to say that that's, you know, put it together, make sure it looks okay, that the ad is the proper one and all that. And then this is all new. Someone from the board is going to have to stop by when I have all these things collected and sign them.
I can do that, Mary. Just let me know.
It's just that I have all this to do.
Yeah.
And this all has to be, they all have to be done by June 30th. Everything has to be done before June 30th. But, you know, the minutes don't, except that the minutes are supposed to be done earlier than that in order to keep us out of court. Every time I think there's time, email has just been horrendous. The job is so different from when I started doing it in 2009. We didn't even use email back then. I'm not trying to excuse things. I'm just saying, to say when I'm gonna, I thought I was gonna have minutes done now. I'll certainly have something done this month, but I don't know when. The planning board has even older ones that are still due to them.
Just do the best you can, Mary. That's all we can ask for. Do the best.
That's what I'm planning on.
Okay.
You know, and the backup is, with the exception of last month, due to my error, we do have a record, the video of our
yes. meeting. However, that doesn't speed things up.
No,
if I go to them, it's because I need to, you know.
Mary, I only meant to keep us out of court when you.
Oh yes,
that.
Yes.
So that if God forbid we needed a record, we have a record. But I agree with Roger. Just, you know, to do the best you can.
I am doing the best I can. I'll continue to do so. I hope I have some minutes that I can put in the pot real soon.
Okay.
Mary, do you need more hours to do some of this work?
I don't have a limit on my hours. It's that I don't have enough hours to devote to this work, I guess is what I can put to it.
Not enough hours in the day.
Yeah.
Okay, it's not getting paid the hours that we pay.
It's got nothing to do with getting paid, except that now that the end of the fiscal year is coming up, I also have that to deal with. I have to come up with all the work I did since, you know, January so that I can get paid for that. It's right. At this point, and there, I didn't expect that there would be any problem about getting paid, but between what happened in April and May for work, I have no idea right now what that's going to come up to.
Well, this will just sort of be off the record, even though it can be on the record. Have you ever considered a timekeeping computer program? We have that at work. And I just, if I work 0.25 hours on a case, I punch it in right then as I'm done with the work. And I don't have to think about it again. And there's no going backwards.
Well, not being the tech savvy person that a lot of people are. I have no idea how to do anything with that. Right now, I'm looking for a new computer. My old one's falling apart. I can't really load anything more onto it right now. I'm gonna have to get something else. It would be nice to have something that tracks hours so that I don't have to do it at the end. I'd certainly be willing to think about that once I have something that I can load it onto.
Well, I'll just look up some sort of simple program and just.
I'm sorry.
I'll send you a link. I'll look up something that's a basic timekeeping program and I'll just send you a link. But yes, it will take up computer space. So that'll be another threshold to cross. Mm-hmm. But I'll look up something for you.
Thanks, Roger.
Okay. You're welcome.
Roger, do we have a way of helping Mary, say, with a new computer if she can't, the one she has isn't. Can't keep up with the work?
That's not the problem. The computer can keep up with the work. I'm saying my computer is coming to the end of its days and I need to replace it. I haven't not been able to work on it.
Right, but I think Fred's saying would the town pay for a new computer, basically what he's saying. I don't know. I don't mind asking Brian though. Unless you have an objection to that, Mary.
I'd rather hold off on something like that. Thanks.
Okay.
Analyzing a big bank.
Or ones that the town is replacing. I don't know what their schedule is. Even an older one they're replacing may be better for Mary to use. I don't know.
I'm getting a new one, no matter what.
Okay.
I
thank you for the suggestions. I'll deal with it. It's just that everything's happening at once.
I understand.
All right. Okay. Don't worry about it, Mary.
If it had spread itself out more, we wouldn't be in this pickle. I had never seen anything like all this stuff that happened in April and May.
Were busy months. They were busy.
Maybe you need another month on the calendar.
I know.
13 months.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, all everybody. Right.
Are we officially closing this meeting?
We are officially closing this meeting.